Let's start with the brown bread and go over here, shall we?
Hmm.
I suppose brown bread, more roughage and better for you, supposedly.
I think it's much better for you, but I'm told by the that it, in fact it isn't any better for you, but it's just much nicer to eat. In the recipe that I'm doing, I put half white flour, but it must be strong flour, and that's
What is strong flour, isn't it?
Strong flour is made from a hard wheat, usually a Canadian wheat, and it's the sort that you use for something like bread or pastry. And then I'm using half whole wheat flour, nothing added, nothing taken away. In fact, some people are even grinding their own these days. I have a girlfriend who does it herself and shares it with other people in the village. So in the bowl is 12 ounces of brown, 12 ounces of white, 2 teaspoonfuls of sugar, now this, and 2 teaspoonfuls of salt, putting the salt in first. Now, I'm not sieving the flour because I find my sieve is, in fact, too fine to take the brown.
And you don't think it's necessary?
No, you mix it all in later. So at that stage...
So altogether, that is 1.5 pounds of flour, isn't it?
That's right. Mm. So that is all, those are the dry ingredients in the bowl. And now we come to the liquid. And the liquid in this particular brown loaf is water. And I want it hand-hot liquid. Judy, this is the temperature of hot bath water because I'm using dried yeast.
And you've got cold water from the tap and then you're just adding...
hot water to make it the right temperature.
Right. And how... what's the amount of water you've got? How many?
It's 15 fluid ounces, that's 3/4 of a pint, of hand hot. And if that's because I'm using dried yeast, a little bit cooler if you're using fresh yeast. I'm using dried yeast because that's what you can get readily at the supermarket.
So it's because of convenience. I mean, if people want to use the live...
fresh yeast, you can use fresh yeast. It's difficult to come by. A level tablespoon.
And how
many? Either a tablespoon like that or a tablespoon like that. Doesn't matter, it's all the same. And then to feed the yeast, we've got warmth and we now need a bit of sugar to feed the yeast. And you don't put all the sugar in with the water because if you do, it slows it down, funnily enough. So you remember I put 2 teaspoons in there and 1 teaspoon in here.
And the amount of yeast, you say, is just...
is 1/2 ounce. So it's really very easy. Now, if this didn't frost now, it would mean the yeast was old. Don't mess about with it. Throw it out and go and buy some new yeast. It doesn't keep forever. You can buy it in packets or you can buy it in a tin, but even in the tin, it won't keep for more than 6 months. So there we are. I'm going to leave that to froth up, and I've got one here already frothed up.
That has taken how long to get like that?
15 minutes, just about exactly. There we are.
And so then it's ready to go in with the flour.
That's right. And I'm just going to level the flour and I'm going to put a bit of oil in because that helps to make it a bit moist. Just a tablespoonful of oil. You can use lard if you like. Then put all the liquid in at once. Is it all
this effervescing?
The smell is absolutely delicious. Now remember, dried yeast to use baking yeast, not brewer's yeast. And I mix with a fork because I find it best to mix with a fork. Always at this stage, in with the hand. Now, when you used to make bread, it was always you must have warmth. And I find in my own family, it's much easier to, after this stage, to not try and do it with too much heat because it does it too quickly. I found this morning that it's taken 2 hours to rise just in the kitchen and it's not a particularly warm day. It takes about 2 hours to rise. On a hot day, it'll take about 1.5 hours.
I think this is what puts people off a bit, isn't it? They're thinking about the temperature of the room and the temperature of this, that and the other, of the old days of baking bread.
It doesn't matter. What I do is I start off in the morning making bread and I put the water and the dried yeast and the sugar And that takes 15 minutes. I nip up and make the beds. I can do the family beds in 15 minutes. Then I come down and I mix up the dough, and that's a couple of hours to leave it to rise. And I might nip out shopping. And also, if you're doing it slowly, it doesn't matter one bit if you're half an hour late. Mm. I think people are alarmed. They think they've got to stay at home.
Yeah. You're not only baking the bread, you're giving us a schedule for the housework in the morning as well.
Well, I'm not really that keen on it. There we are. So that's the bowl quite clean. And then to the kneading. And at this stage, you want to knead it as my little brother. Do you remember when my little son made it here? He said, I love the thumping of bread.
Yes.
So knead it, and that's pressing it down.
Mm.
Different people do it different ways. You can do it like this, but I like it all the way around. And then just scrape down the fingers. Now, go on doing that for 10 minutes, about 10 minutes, or you can do it using an electric machine, and then put it in an oil bag. Now, I've got one and I want to have it alongside. That's been 2 hours just in the kitchen, not near the cooker, and that's its double bulk.
And when you say an oiled bag, that's just with sort of some...
A polythene bag that's been oiled with a bit of... vegetable oil, or even lard if you're using lard. Mm. So there it is, double the size. And let's put this one for a couple of hours in there, or 40 minutes under the grill. Now you can see the difference in size.
Yes, there's an incredible difference. You, how many times do you have to sort of bring it down as you're
doing? Just once.
Just the once.
So just knock it back to its original size, kneading it well. Now I would do that for about 4 minutes. And then I'm going to make 2 loaves from this. Can I stretch across you for the knife? So, just knead that. And
this
I like to have lots
to
of help
doing
in
that.
The kitchen. This is one thing that the children can't ruin. They come in thumping away the bread. I do like them to stay in the kitchen and wash their hands first, but they love it, and they're very likely to eat it afterwards. So there's one. Loaf, just put on a greased tin.
That's a tin that has many uses, isn't it, in your kitchen? We've used it a lot before, so it's not a special tin, as you say.
It's a non-stick one, it's just a jolly nice one, and it's greased.
Mm.
And there we are, that's the other one. And I'm going to drop that in a well-greased flower pot. Now, you see, there's actually a hole in the bottom of the flower pot. I don't bother to fill that in. You can put
the
a little
bit of
foil. The
dough doesn't seep out, sort of in an unseemly fashion at the bottom.
There
right.
we are. So there's two ready to rise, and you want to then put those in a greased polythene bag, and they want to rise till double the size, and that will be, under the grill, or when it's off and it's warm, that would take about half an hour, or an hour and a half.
And then it comes out looking like this.
That's had about an hour and a half.
Very good. Doesn't it?
And there's one in a flower pot. And if you want to glaze it with a little bit of milk. Just helps to give a shiny top.
Then you've put some bits on the top.
Cracked wheat, if you want
Cracked
to.
Cracked wheat.
Lovely. You can buy that in one of the health food shops.
That's indeed where you can get the yeast there, can't you? The dried yeast there, if you can't get it at your chemist.
Cook it at 425, 450 for about 30 minutes to 40 minutes. Can you open the oven door for me? It won't be hot, the oven door.
Sorry.
There we are. And they won't rise anymore. The moment they go in the oven, the yeast is killed and they've risen to their full amount, and then it will just brown and cook through.
What's the basin there?
Well, I find if you have a basin full of water in the bottom, it makes a nice steamy atmosphere in the oven, and you'll find that you won't get too hard a crust if you're making white bread.
Oh. And you leave that in for between 30 and 40 minutes?
At 425 to 450, 7 to 8.
Mm. How do you tell it's done?
Well, I've got a loaf here, Judy. You give it a bang underneath, and it wants to sound hollow. You'll find it may take on the longer side if you do it in a flower pot. Mm. It's a shorter side if you just do it on a baking sheet.
Mm.